Hello and welcome to Iceland. This time I have a special treat, or one of those videos that are suitable both for my geology and tourist playlists. And this is the Tjornes Peninsula, shaped by tectonic and volcanic activity associated with the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. And unlike much of Iceland, it features a thick sequence of sedimentary layers, and some of them are over 500 meters deep. These layers were deposited between approximately 4.5 to 1.5 million years ago, and during this time, the region experienced fluctuating sea levels, which helped form distinct strata of marine and terrestrial sediments. So I can proudly say that later in this video I will be presenting a cross-section tilting shot covering several million years, and other rare visuals as well. And today's video was filmed during two trips, first in 2024, shortly after a rainy day that made some of the layers pop very well. And as I was getting ready to edit the footage, it felt as a good idea to bring the new drone that has this extremely good zoom lens. And I'm not sure if experts can explain everything that's going on there, but if so, it would be very much appreciated, since I'm using my footage to learn, and my comment section is always open for explanations. So if there are any experts out there with good knowledge in this department, I would be very thankful for all information, even a Zoom interview, to help us to understand what elements were at work there. And it is extraordinary to stand there in front of those millions of years, where sea shells are popping out from those layers all around from erosion, and they actually smell and look like the shells we find just by the sea. But what we are looking at are layers of organic deposits. When the Earth's crust last moved, then the layers got pushed up from the seabed, and from these fossils it's possible to trace changes in climate, vegetation, and marine life from the beginning of the Ice Age, and also how species migrated, adapted, or went extinct. And amongst the fossilized shells are specimens from the Pacific Ocean, which could only have traveled through the Bering Strait in earlier times. But this also proves that Iceland was once upon a time in warm climate. And what has the Earth's magnetic poles to do with all that? And I have to admit that I'm not the expert in that department, but this is my kind of footage though. And since I'm getting a bit out of my league as for knowledge in this, I'm leaving links to reports in the video description for those who want to dive deeper. And I would gladly do an interview with someone with knowledge to do this place justice. So this video might just be a warm-up. I know of other places of significance in the neighborhood, and I'm sure I would have to film them as well for the full story. So I'm not making the voiceover part of this video much longer, so we can use the rest of it to concentrate on the visuals from this best-known fossil site in the country. So geology students come here all the time, and there is a little guest house and a coffee shop open there now, so I'm leaving location links for you. And if you come visit, remember to show this place respect, so it can remain open for us all to explore such a huge part of history at this one little location. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.